What's going on, everyone? Model Deer Farmer back with you today on the channel here doing American farming. We're here today again. We're cutting some hay at the moment. We're hoping the game doesn't crash too much today. Got the one tractor here cutting hay. Looks like our combine is full, so we better take care of that here real quick before we get on into things. Looks like we are going to have to go unload some corn here. Getting some good corn crop here. Got the time scaled back a little bit right now just because we are doing the hay over on the hay field, and I don't really want that to get cut and then grow back up in grass before we can get it picked up. So we're gonna get on it today, get this thing unloaded. I think our grain train is pretty much full, so we may have to go see what to do with that. We'll head on over there and get this thing unloaded. And that did not take too much. The grain train is full now, so we are gonna need to go unload that. Wow, this field's looking beautiful. Working on forage harvesting over here, but yeah, it's not going great, we'll say that. Part of the thing is we need a way bigger forage harvester, but that's my opinion. We are going to get over into the grain train here, and I guess we're gonna go try and fill the hogs, but since we've kind of been running time slower right now, we really haven't used much corn for the hogs. Once we get this hay baled up, we will put the time a little bit faster again, just to kind of get things caught up, get things cycling through, and get on top of things, if I didn't already say that. This is definitely getting a little slow for this machine here. Get unloaded here, see how much it takes. That did not use much at all. We barely emptied anything out of that one. We emptied like maybe a third out of it. So now time to head over to the main farm, get those hogs fed, and the rest we will put into storage for now. Also, hey, we're 4 minutes into recording and we have not crashed the game yet today, which, like, the last episode we crashed like 3 times by now or something. So we are making improvements. I don't believe there's been an update, but I'm getting my settings dialed into what I think the best looking game for still being able to run it without crashing it. So that's all going great today. After about 10 years, we are almost up here to the farmyard now. Get this corn unloaded. Pull up next to there and get unloading. Well, we took out a second wagon, whatever. We'll see which one uses more. Probably the other one. We did not get very far on that one either. We will go ahead and put the rest in the bins over here. The tractor's sort of in the way. We'll see if we can sneak through because I really don't. Okay, that works too. It didn't really work that well. Yeah, we'll just forget you saw that. I don't think you've seen anything there. We definitely are able to run time faster because we definitely do have plenty of corn. It's the hay side of things with the cattle that's tough to keep up with because we got 6,500 bushels of corn in our grain system right now. Here's a question for you guys. Maybe you guys know this better than I do. Can we feed the cattle? Can we feed them corn? I highly doubt it, but there could be the possibility. So let me know if you guys know. And I got a message saying that someone was full. Look at that. The combine is already full before we can even get anything unloaded out of here. And this thing is still too full, so I'm not going to go over and load him because that's just going to make a big mess of things. And he's about full too. We're kind of running around with our heads cut off at the moment. This thing's empty though. Man, can't talk either. Let's head on back out to the field, get the grain cart unloaded, and send the grain cart off to go unload the combine again. There we go, one full gravity wagon already. We're going to start filling the second one there just a little bit. Now we can go run over and unload the combine. He's getting close to being done with this field, which means then we'll be able to get the corn planter started going on it. We can run 3 helpers at a time right now, and I believe we're only... Never mind, we are running 3. I kind of forgot about the silage over there. So we might have to figure out what we're not going to run. We might stop running silage for a while. I think we're kind of running out of corn to do that with right now anyways. Got him unloaded, so he's going to take off there, and we are probably going to end up having to go unload our forage harvester, and we're going to decide then if we want to do any more. He is cleaning up a little bit of what he messed up, but Still not going to be great, I don't think. We're going to take a look here in our storage and look at what we have here on the dairy farm. We have 118,000 pounds in the silo right now. That can probably be a pretty decent amount of silage, which we probably are going to need to feed the cows here because, yeah, they're pretty much all out of food. So we will go ahead and get that done here. Once this silage gets filled up, I'm probably just going to leave the rest of it for combining because I don't really want to deal with any more of this. It just becomes a mess. And our new silage field is going to be this small little one over on the corner of the farm over there, which we're lagging really bad right now. Love it. Anyways, we got our forage harvesting done that we're probably going to do right now. So, I mean, this is a pretty sweet rig. I like it. It just takes a really long time. And I know it kind of does get tough because Case IH is one of the main only brands that we have in the game. And they do not have a self-propelled forage harvester. So it does get kind of tough. They might have to find something else. Like maybe if they can get New Holland to come on board, which they are owned by Case IH. So, I mean, I feel like it wouldn't be that bad to get them. But I don't know. It'd be cool to see New Holland in here as well. We will get that dumping over here into our harvester silo, or at least I thought we were. There we go, now we're going here. And then we're probably gonna hook this thing up to the feed wagon and go load out a couple loads of feed. There we go, we got that unhooked. We're gonna hook up to the feed wagon here. Now we also will be getting a little bit more feed supply with our bales that we're gonna pull off this time. So we might end up, I don't know, I think you can put them into the harvester and maybe it amounts to more, so I think we might try that just to get a little bit more amount of feed off of it. At least we don't have to drive too far to fill this thing up and empty it out. The thing that gets me on this one though is we have to be this direction. If I try pulling up to it and unloading the left side, it does not work. So keep that in mind when you are working on the cattle stuff here, feeding them. But we got one load emptied out, so let's go over here to the harvester and pull another one out. And this one will go to the actual dairy cows. That one we were taking to the dairy calves. I don't know if we have to like go and put them into the other pasture or if they just magically go over there themselves. I haven't looked into that yet. I also don't think that we've had them long enough for any of them to be old enough though, so I keep going past the trigger here. I see it and I stop and then it's just like right out of area. There we go. We can get that filled up now. We're going to grab a couple more loads and throw them in there because one load on each of them really is not going to last that long and I ran into the shed. Well, we'll try and get unstuck here. It'd be really nice if we had one of those big feed trailers that go behind a semi because those we could just fill up down at the co-op or something with a whole bunch. Truck it back here and unload, like it would work really nice, but we don't have the funds for that right now, and it would just take forever to run loads back and forth with this thing, and I don't think it'd really be worth it. We've tried doing it in the past with hogs and it didn't pay out then either, so we'll just keep doing it this way for now. See, and the cattle have so much feed storage, we have literally put two entire trailer loads in, and that is all the feed supply we have. That's one on the dairy calf side of things too. Also, we're down to 130,000 pounds on the harvester. So we're quickly depleting that, it seems like. Great, and we got the tractor stuck now. I keep turning the wrong time here and getting stuck. Come to think of it, getting a load of feed for the cattle farm up here wouldn't be too bad because we have a co-op right there, literally, but still, I think we're going to just be running back and forth with this thing to the silo quick. We're going to grab one more load. I think that'll make five loads on the dairy cattle and then maybe add one more for the dairy calves. There we go. Got a little bit of feed now in there as well as in the dairy calf area. So we're going to call that good for now because mostly I'm just tired of taking loads back and forth there because it gets old after a while. But we're gonna head take this tractor over here, maybe get it hooked up to the hay rake here and just get that ready because that's gonna be the next thing that we're gonna be doing here once our tractor gets done with mowing, which is going to take a while because of the way the AI workers work this field. They go over there and then they come all the way over here to work this side, I think. So takes a little while. Combine is of course full again. It's been full for a long time, but I've kind of ignored it because I was in the middle of getting the cattle feed. So we're gonna come over here, get it unloaded, probably go unload the grain cart into the grain train, and then see what else we got to do, because there's always something to do and we're kind of falling behind at this point a little bit. Man, I'm having a trouble some time getting over to these gravity wagons right now, but we got the back one filled up. Start filling the middle one, probably won't get it completely full, but we will have another grain train full of corn. Well, we might actually fill it up. We might have filled it up. I don't know, it's going to be a close one, but I don't really want to unload that right now. I probably should, but we're not going to. We're going to check on the map here and see. I don't remember what's all what right now. Growth. Yep, pretty much the next thing is to plant that field the combine's on right now. And the mower's still going, so I guess we will go and take the grain train again, as much as I really don't want to right now. I won't make you guys sit through it though. So I know we were talking about getting a really big tractor to pull around the grain train here and take care of that, but that's gonna be a lot of money. So honestly, at this point, I'm kind of considering if we just spend our money and get a semi grain trailer as well as a semi truck and just do that and haul our grain that way. It's gonna be a lot quicker. We're probably gonna be able to hold about the same amount as this, if not more corn at a time. And I feel like that's gonna work out better, and it's gonna be a little bit cheaper on the money side of things instead of me wanting to try and buy a Magnum to pull this thing around at 35 mile an hour or whatever it goes. So I think we may look towards that. I feel like this one grain bin is gonna be full here pretty soon, because max of 10,000 bushels in these things, and I think we're getting pretty darn close to that. I think we're about at close to 9,000 bushels, and it holds 10,000, so we will be full here pretty soon. That's a lot of corn, so definitely I feel like we could sell some of that off, but I don't really want to take that over with this just because of how long it takes. We might do that in the future, but we're not going to do that today. I feel like we've been harvesting this field of corn also for like the last three episodes, and so it's kind of dragging on, and I kind of want to get on to something different. But we've been kind of more involved with the cattle side of things, so I haven't really been paying attention as much to this and keeping the combine moving, and it looks like it is full again. Faster tractor for this grain cart though would be nice. I mean, this thing rocking 20 mile an hour, just honestly, it ain't cutting it. It is not quite cutting it. Down to about one or maybe two passes to go on the field here for the combine, and then he's going to be wrapping it up, which is going to be nice because then we can get our planter rolling on this, and we're going to need to put nitrogen and P and K on, so lots of stuff we're going to have to be doing with this field. Might have to do some of it manually, but we're not going to deal with that right now. Got to get the corn finished up and then get the combine moved on to the next field. Especially on big fields like this, I would love if we could run two combines on the same field. That's really the only reason I've only stuck to one combine. It's because I don't want to have to run back and forth between two fields. So that's kind of why we've been doing that. It would be nice to be able to hire two combines, like start one on this end and one on the other, kind of like how you can do in Farm Sim, but is what it is, I guess, for now. But we're also kind of running out of time in the episode today, so I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, give it a like. Also, consider subscribing to the channel. We're trying to hit 3,000 subscribers by the end of the year. We are just about at 800 left to go. I think we can get there. We still got, I can't do math, but 4 or 5 months. So let's go ahead and get there. If you have any comments or questions, you can leave those down in the comment section below. But I hope you guys all enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and this is Model Deer Farmer, and I will see you all in the next one.